NAB is right around the corner, and Softron is ready to welcome all of you to fabulous Las Vegas. Let's start out with the newly released MovieRecorder 453. There are a number of improvements here, from UI refinement, remote control abilities, but let's talk about some of the new features since last NAB. We have the new web-based schedule recordings. Now, I highlighted this schedule on this channel, so if you want to learn more about this, I have a video in the description below. Another feature you might have missed is the inclusion of Avid DNX HR with Apple Silicon computers, so you should see improved performances when recording with the M1 or M2 computers. For DeltaCast video cards, we added support for Rec 2020 Wide Gamut and HDR, which is great as we also announced the new M8 bundles. This puts together the best recording software with the best video card in one easy bundle, packaged to meet your needs. In the setup, we add support for audio track languages. And another important feature is the NDI audio reference level. NDI uses floating point audio levels, and unfortunately, some devices have a hard-coded reference point when converting to a real audio level. This could cause audio to be significantly louder in MovieRecorder. Now we have a 20 decibel option to correct for these devices. There's a lot more inside MovieRecorder 4.53, available for download now from our website. Let's talk about video playback. OnTheAir Video continues to serve the great broadcasting community, and it's amazing to see the ranges from churches and local government all the way to TV channels to major 24/7 broadcasters. Now, new in OnTheAir Video 4.13, the ability to change the clip and behavior of a clip as it's playing. So if you want to add a loop, a hold, or a play next to the end of a clip, that is possible. Clips can also be replaced with a separate clip, but keep the existing actions in place. And for better ease of use, we have added multiple comment color choices. This is great for sectioning your playlist documents by type or use case. Looking at the playhead section, we have two new improvements. First is the timer. These panes are now customizable with many different countdown choices, including to next comment and selected item. And these two options, next live item or clocked item, can even be automatically switched by which one comes next under the auto selector. We're also now showing when an item is added to play next. The playhead expands to show you what is next, and you have quick access to go to that item or clear that clip. We've also added so much more support for peripheral devices. Starting with our GPI commander, we now have multi-usage. Now, we showed this on the channel not too long ago, but it's even better now with a more extensive feature list. And we've also added the ability to trigger Blackmagic Design ATEM macros from Apple scripts. So now a clip could tell your ATEM what to do as it's playing. OnTheAir Video is really loved for the many ways it could be controlled, and we've added some features to make it even better. Now in the REST API, you can resynchronize the schedule. This is great for users who want to control the schedule, but don't actually have access to the device. You can also check what the next live item is and the remaining time of that item. Another really exciting feature is now we offer a thumbnail of the video output to get a preview of OnTheAir Video's current video for users who need to keep a close eye on the OnTheAir product. With so many ways to remotely control OnTheAir Video, one of the issues we knew about was when many users wanted to tweak the playlist at the same time. Screen sharing was being overwhelmed with users fighting for control of the same mouse. We wanted the experience of OnTheAir Video to be available to everyone, so we're proud to introduce Remote Pack. Remote Pack makes OnTheAir Video available on any type of machine with just a browser. Users can open and control playlists while keeping the same feel as the macOS experience. The normal commands like play, skip, pause, cue are available, but the media may also be arranged. Comments show up in color, just like they do on the server. Multiple users can control and adjust a document without needing to fight for a mouse. This allows for dynamic new views, like columns, a great solution if you need to quickly trigger a certain clip. Considering OnTheAir Video can also play images and audio files, this will be great for a number of workflows. With these new features, we needed more responsibility. We added authenticated users. This allows limitations on controls users require and logs are changes made to the playout. Remote Pack also adds another powerful feature, Media Browser, a catalog of available media now ready to go on air. Users can drag these items into the playlist without connecting to the media storage. Users will be able to preview, mark in and out points, add graphics and smart actions, and this will update to every playlist that uses that file. We think Remote Pack is going to be such a great feature for so many of you. And for those of you running newscasts, the OnTheAir MOS Gateway has a newly redesigned plugin. This plugin allows the creation of MOS objects, new filtering options and search fields, and the dynamic linking of media files to a MOS object. Users are even able to assign action templates to an item or edit the item right in the OnTheAir video playlist, and it stays with the MOS object. So these new features are just great when talking about MovieRecorder or OnTheAir video. On this channel, we've talked a lot about what Apple Silicon can do as far as recording. You'll see with MovieRecorder on the Mac Studio M1 Ultra, we're using 5 Thunderbolt ports to do 10 4K 60 ProRes HQ encodes. That's 6 Thunderbolt left over for storage. With the new Mac Mini M2 Pros, we were able to do 6 4K 60 records and that last Thunderbolt for storage. The new unified memory architecture saves us from any bandwidth limitations. The CPU and the GPU's shared memory means those graphics can now be used right from the GPU into the playout. So you can have up to 8 OnTheAir CG channels, which already have dynamic layers and transition to use 8K graphics feeding into your switcher now. So for those of you lucky enough to join us here in Las Vegas, please stop by the booth and we'd love to show you all the new things we've been working on. Thanks for watching.